mercifully grant that we may thankfully receive the same, in remembrance of him who in these holy mysteries giveth us a pledge of life eternal, the same thy Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who now liveth and reigneth with thee in the Holy Spirit, one God, world without end.
Thank you. broke it and said, "This is my body that is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, he took the cup also after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. Whoever, therefore, eats the bread or drinks the cup of the Lord in an unworthy manner will be answerable for the body and blood of the Lord. Examine yourselves, and only then eat of the bread and drink of the cup. For all who eat and drink without discerning the body eat and drink judgment against themselves. For this reason, many of you are weak and ill, and some have died. But if we judged ourselves, we would not be judged. But when we are judged by the Lord, we are disciplined, so that we may not be condemned along with the world." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Around him. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Lord, are you going to wash my feet?" Jesus answered, "You do not know now what I am going to do, but later you will understand." Peter said to him, "You will never wash my feet." Jesus answered, "Unless I wash you, you have no share with me." Simon Peter said to him, "Lord, not my feet only, but also my hands and my head." Jesus said to him, "One who has bathed does not need to wash except for the feet, but it is entirely clean. And you are clean, though not all of you." For he knew who was to betray him. For this reason he said, "Not all of you are clean." After he had washed their feet, had put on his robe, and had returned to the table, he said to them, "Do you know what I have done to you? You call me teacher and Lord, and you are right, for this is what I am. So if I, your Lord and teacher, have washed your feet, you also ought to wash one another's feet. For I have set you an example, that you also should do as I have done to you." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Tonight is the beginning of the end. I mean, we did kick off Holy Week this past Sunday with the triumphant palm procession, but tonight is Maundy Thursday. Its name coming from the commandment that is given by Christ to his disciples. "A new commandment I have given to you, that you love one another as I have loved you." Our readings tonight give us a few different commandments as well. First from Exodus, which takes us back almost to the beginning of the story of salvation. God tells Moses and Aaron what to do for this Passover that is coming. Getting a perfect, unblemished young lamb, sacrificing and then eating, partaking of the Passover lamb. This whole sequence is a powerful foreshadowing of what happens tonight before Jesus' betrayal. Then in Corinthians, Paul shares what our Lord did at the Last Supper. The words that we use literally every time we gather for the Eucharist should sound very familiar here from Corinthians. We are told that this is what he said and did, and then to eat this bread and drink this cup, and in that we proclaim the Lord's death. We do this in remembrance of Christ. There's a focused encouragement to look to Christ, to see what he said and see what he did, and to follow his examples. And that's how he finishes the whole discussion in John, telling his disciples to do as he did. In this gospel from John, it starts near the Passover. This was the hour for Christ was to depart this world, it says. St. John tells this Last Supper similarly to the other gospels, but he presents something different that Matthew, Mark, and Luke do not have. We have the sequence where Christ bends down and washes the feet of his disciples. John's gospel reveals something very important and powerful about Jesus' inner self, about his disposition, about how he feels about people. His attitude of self-giving both to the church and to the world, to all of us. In this moment that we just heard of him kneeling down and placing himself at the feet of his followers, it opens the eyes of the disciples. It opens our eyes, too, to see what really happens
both in the institution of the Eucharist and every Eucharist following, is that it's an opportunity to share in the love of a servant. All through the Gospels, we see Jesus hangs out in many different people's homes. There are scenes of healing and eating and gathering and in fellowship, but here the scene is unique because Jesus is the host. So often he's being welcomed in, but here he is the host, and it says it is his turn to wash the feet of his guests, which is not uncommon for people to wash their feet coming in from the dusty road, but that usually would be done by a servant of the house, not by the host, not by the master. It's a really menial and lowly task that only, you know, Gentile slaves were required to do it. But it's a gracious act of hospitality for guests, again, coming in and being ready to share in fellowship with the people gathered. In Luke's account, the disciples were arguing about who was the greatest. And Jesus asked them rhetorically, and he says, who is greater, the one who sits at the table or the one who serves? And the scene of him washing the feet of his followers is his answer to that question. This gesture of washing of feet is a tangible demonstration of what love for another means and looks like. In this simple action, we see Jesus in the most true way that he is. We see his purpose, which ultimately is simply to serve. And we've seen the front of the booklet tonight is a beautiful painting from Peter Paul Rubens. Take a look. And we see the scene of the foot washing depicted. All the apostles gathered around, but the focus of the painting focuses very clearly on Peter and Christ. You can see Peter looks a little wary, and Jesus is opening his arms, literally saying, come on, Peter, let me wash your feet. And Peter says, you will not wash my feet. He can't even imagine his Lord doing something that is so beneath of a master. Earlier, Peter spoke similarly when Jesus tells his disciples in Matthew that he must suffer and die, and Peter pipes up and says, not you. Far be it from you, Lord. This will never be done to you. Now, Peter is sort of quick to speak his mind because he feels that this is something that our Lord should not be doing. You can see in the depiction there from the painting that he looks somewhat awkward or embarrassed, or some type of uncomfortable, that in his mind, this is his Lord, the King of Kings. Why should he be doing the work of a servant? A thing always reserved for the lowliest servants to do. In the small exchange, the struggle that many of us might feel being presented with a gracious gift is perfectly articulated and expressed. This is the struggle to fully accept and humble oneself to the point of being able to accept such a perfect gift. This is a sacrifice of love, the love that loves to the end, a love that Peter struggles to accept and questions, to accept the gift of Christ that he offers to us. It's a tangible act that we have to do, that we have to choose to decide to accept. During this washing, Christ acts out this prophetic sign of his whole life and mission. The sacrificial Lamb of God fulfills the Passover that we read from Exodus. And then in the text here it says, he first lays down his outer garment before he begins. And then he takes it up again, just like the good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep and takes up his life again. On the night he was betrayed, Christ invites his disciples to follow him in that way of sacrifice. This is the night that all of us know what is about to happen.
And as we wait with the Lord at the garden all night at the watch, we know of the imminent betrayal. There's only two disciples named in this sequence. And they sort of represent two ways of responding to what our Lord offers. Judas, the son of Simon, rejects the invitation the devil had already put in his heart to betray our Lord. And then Peter hesitates. The gift presents to Christ with a towel around himself, arms open, saying, "Please let me wash your feet." And eventually he accepts that gift. The encouragement is for us to accept the gift and follow as he asks. "For I have set you an example, that you also should do as I have done to you." Let us do as our Lord commands.
Fellow servants of our Lord Jesus Christ, on the night before his death, Jesus set an example for his disciples by washing their feet, an act of humble service. He taught that strength and growth in the life of the kingdom of God come not by power, authority, or even miracle, but by such lowly service. We all need to remember his example. But none stand more in need of this reminder than those whom the Lord has called to the ordained ministry. Therefore, I invite you, who share in the royal priesthood of Christ, to come forward, that I may recall whose servant I am by following the example of my master. But come, remembering his admonition, that what will be done for you is also to be done by you to others. For a servant is not greater than his master, nor is the one who is sent greater than the one who sent him. If you know these things, blessed are you if you do them.
Thank you.
that your name may be glorified by all people.
We pray for all bishops, priests, and deacons,
that they may be faithful ministers of your word and sacraments.
We pray for all who govern and hold authority in the nations of the world,
that there may be justice and peace on the earth.
Give us grace to do your will in all that we undertake,
and that our works may find favor in your sight.
Have compassion on those who suffer from any grief or trouble,
that they may be delivered from their distress.
Give to the departed eternal rest.
Let thy perpetual shine upon them.
We praise you for your saints who have entered into joy.
May we also come to share your heavenly kingdom.
Let us pray for our own needs and those of others.
Almighty God, whose most dear Son went not up to joy, but first he suffered pain, and entered not into glory before he was crucified, mercifully grant that we, walking in the way of the cross, may find it none other than the way of life and peace. Through the same thy Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Ye who do truly and earnestly repent you of your sins, and are in love and charity with your neighbors, and intend to lead a new life, following the commandments of God, and walking from henceforth in his holy ways, draw near with faith, and make your humble confession to Almighty God, devoutly deemed.
Participate in the watch tonight, please make sure on the way out that you check out those easels and plug the holes, and every year the holes always get plugged, but it's a wonderful way to spend an hour with the Lord. It's in the chapel directly following the service. It goes all night until tomorrow morning, and it ends with morning prayer at 9 a.m.
Later tonight, the youth are watching a movie. It's a Risen. It's called Risen. Spoiler alert, it's about Jesus. He rises from something. It'll be in the parking lot on the other side of the parish hall. So if you're wanting to participate in that, everyone's welcome. The youth are watching it, but everybody's certainly welcome. And then you can see the schedule for the rest of the Holy 3 days that we'll be celebrating over the next several days. Walk in love as Christ loves us and gave himself for us, an offering and sacrifice to God.
Thank you.
We acclaim thee, Holy Lord, glorious in power, whose mighty works reveal thy wisdom and love. Thou hast formed us in thine own image, giving the whole world into our care, that in obedience unto thee, our Maker, we might rule and serve all thy creatures. When our disobedience took us far from thee, thou didst not abandon us to the power of death, but in thy mercy thou didst come to our help, that in seeking thee we might find thee. Again and again thou didst call us into covenant with thee through the prophets, thou didst teach us to hope for salvation. Thou didst so love the world, O Father, that in the fullness of time, thou didst send thine only begotten Son to be our Savior, incarnate by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary. He lived to prisoners' freedom, to the sorrowful joy, that thy purpose might be fulfilled. He gave himself up unto death, and rising from the grave, he destroyed death and made the whole creation new. And that we might live no longer unto ourselves, but unto him who died for us and rose again, he sent the Holy Spirit, his own first gift for those who believe, to complete his work in the world, bringing to fulfillment the sanctification when the hour had come for him to be glorified by thee, his heavenly Father, having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. At supper with them he took bread, and when he had given thanks unto thee, he brake it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me. Likewise, after supper he took the cup. When he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, Drink ye all this, for this is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many, for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as you shall drink it, for the remembrance of me.
Minister in thy church. Remember all thy people, and those who seek thy truth. Remember those about to be baptized, particularly John.
Remember all who have died in the peace of Christ, and those whose faith is known to thee alone. Bring them into the place of eternal happiness, joy, and light.
And grant that we may find our inheritance with the Blessed Virgin Mary, with patriarchs, prophets, apostles, and martyrs, with Blessed Lawrence, our patron, and all the saints who have found favor with thee in ages past. We praise thee in union with them and give thee glory through thy Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Through Christ and with Christ and in Christ, all honor and glory be unto thee, Almighty God and Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, world without end.
Amen. Son.